the corner and said that if anybody's in the street tonight, they're going to get arrested. Now, keep in mind, there's been people in the street
every night.
Every night. And they never said anything. The only time they ever came out and said, if you impede traffic, you'll be arrested, is if they came out and it was people in traffic already.
Yeah.
And they backed
it's a response,
up. But
not
it
proactive.
Wasn't anybody in traffic, but they're going to come out and say, you'll be arrested if you're out in traffic. Then she shows up with this megaphone speaker on the top of her vehicle, chanting. And now this is the thing that really pissed me off. I probably wouldn't even say nothing, but I feel a way about this thing in particular. They were out here chanting. Now we've been chanting for what, 70 plus days?
70 plus days.
People who are not in St. Louis know these chants, okay?
Hands up, don't shoot. Tell me what democracy is.
I have it as a ringtone.
Okay. All right.
It's not a very hard chance.
Mike Brown means we got to fight back.
We got to fight back.
Okay.
What did she say?
These niggas came out here and just freestyled some chants that we ain't never
seen. We want democracy for
Mike Brown. Everybody was kind of looking around like, what chant is this?
I don't know this. Not
like,
authorized.
No.
It's not authorized.
Coughing all on the mic. Wasn't nobody ever about that. She came out here, she got arrested in under 5 minutes. And that was the plan.
Still strapped.
She'll get out tonight.
Still strapped.
With no, we're not even talking about the fact. We're not even talking about the fact she had a gun on her.
She had a gun on her. She got arrested. I mean, of course, it was probably legal.
But the fact
but they
is,
didn't even take it. They didn't frisk her.
They didn't pat her down.
But they shot a dude who put his hand on his pants because they thought it was a gun. She definitely had a gun.
You hear me? And I'm not saying that she was shot.
I'm just saying.
Let's make that clear.
Let's just show the separation.
What I'm saying is,
when you're a politician, things just change.
No, when you call in an arrest, things change.
Call in an arrest.
That's the difference.
We have
an arrest on a reservation. That's what happened. Miranda, have you heard anybody get Miranda?
No. Nobody. They don't have to anymore. Legally, they don't have to.
Yeah, the Supreme Court ruled.
It wouldn't matter anyway. And if they had to legally, they still wouldn't do it.
You know, right.
They haven't done anything they're supposed to do, so it doesn't matter. But the fact is,
we're
not stupid.
We don't like it. We'll call you out on it.
Don't
come out here for a shit show. Don't come out here because you heard CNN has touched back down. Don't come out here because you see the vans with KSDK flashing on the side. Because when you touch this pavement and you talk to these people who have been consistently sacrificing parts of their lives for this, and you choose when you want to come out here to be a leader of this movement, the movement is not moving if we wait on your leadership. Because you pause and play like this is a damn DVD. We don't have time for that.
Black folks in Missouri, vote Republican. You screwed either which way.
I mean, just do.
If you vote Democrat, you screw, obviously. Because all these people who are trying
to say, at least the Republicans tell you.
The people that we're fighting against right now, they are all Democrats. You know what I'm saying? And they're racist as hell. So there's no such thing as party loyalty. Don't be blind and just vote for somebody just because they're Democrat. Vote Republican, we're screwed either which way. So at least if we're going to be screwed, let's get a point across. That they don't have our vote blindly. The reason they don't do anything for us is because they already know, as a black person, we've already been programmed to vote for Democrats. Regardless of what their stance is, regardless of what platform they're on, we're going to vote for Democrats. So let's put that to rest. Let's make a point, you know, of Republicans going to get into office, they're not going to do anything that we want, just like these Democrats ain't doing. And then maybe, if they beg us hard enough, we might vote them back in for the next election. But for now, vote Republican. I don't even know who a Republican candidate is. I don't even care.
So what now? Jaded. I've been using that word for a few years, y'all.
Okay.
Hey, Occupy and met them, y'all. Remember Anaheim? I was all in the thing.
Y'all make sure CNN don't get shit. Fake media is not allowed here. Leave fake media. Fake reporters, you gotta go.
Mike Brown means
we got to fight back. Fight back.
What's the fight back?
CNN.
Fight back. Fight back. No, I'm giving her a hard time because she's a liar. I'm sorry, man. I'll give her not too much time. All right. But I'm still
going to
give her a hard time.
But I'll still lie. Hey, how you doing?
What's up, Dale?
How you doing?
Am I right? How about you?
She's like tweeting all these wannabe, journalists. So, well, I ain't no journalist. You know what I'm saying? The fake media are the fake journalists. Get your camera and CNN going down the street over there. You don't belong in the middle of protesters. You guys are not American. You're liars. Can you leave? Please. You can get your little short with Jamilah when she gets out. Other than that, you gotta go. Fake media gotta go. You record what you want to record.
They're also asking for media to tell the truth.
Where's
CNN? You was lying to me from fucking California. Fuck shit ass damn bitch. I don't give a fuck, damn it. I don't give a damn. Shut that shit down, cause you be fucking lying.
Fake media don't belong in Ferguson. Take your camera and your fake reporter and go on down the street. It's as simple as that.
How many of y'all was watching CNN after y'all watched the live stream and watched them lie to you and criminalize everybody? How many times did you watch them compromise their journalistic integrity for a fucking paycheck? Stabbing the people in the fucking face who are protecting the same amendment under which they do their job. How do you feel?
Fake media needs to go. We holding y'all accountable from now on. We are all lying.
They said CNN just shut her off.
Yeah, CNN just shut her off.
They watching it.
Damn right CNN just shut
her
off.
Fuck that shit.
Love it.
The reason why people donated from my plane ticket to be here is because y'all be fucking lying.
Tell them. The liars are here, yo.
I don't get paid for this shit. You do. Report the truth.
Fake media is not allowed in Ferguson. Fake media gotta go. We're holding y'all accountable. CNN. Let me know that's CNN, y'all. I don't care. The Sarah is CNN. It's cool. I'm good with it. Hey, but CNN, nah, CNN's a liar, y'all.
When they said the protesters was going to
do
the dirt, CNN is the one that showed my truth.
CNN been lying.
They the ones who showed
my truth. CNN been lying. CNN been lying.
CNN was the one that was telling me that the protesters was violent. CNN told me that the protesters were violent and that they injured officers who were equipped with riot gear and their weapon of choice was a fucking water bottle.
CNN is not
the world knew about what happened out here 2 days before it was on CNN.
CNN lied on Occupy Oakland. CNN lied on Occupy Wall Street. CNN fucking lies on Ferguson.
And Palestine.
CNN was out here pointing into the crowd, saying that y'all was shooting when it was clearly orchestrated by the fucking police.
But real good though.
I'm not fucking lying. I would watch the live stream all night. Then I would watch CNN after press conference prayers and they would lie.
All of them are liars, yo, and all of them gotta go.
Go shake, they're gonna pack it up.
Pack it up. CNN gotta go.
They said that I totally shut it down. Your voice was loud and clear.
Pack that mug up, cuz.
Why? Look. You totally shut it down, and your life was loud and clear. CNN.
Right, real talk. Real talk. That was beautiful, man. I loved it. I loved it.
You can't live up in here.
I just
not on the backs of my, not on the backs of these people.
Nope.
You're not gonna do that. You're not gonna lie on me.
They want out here. We tell our story. Thanks.
You got it.
Thanks, guys. We good, yo.
Make sure you go visit the arts before you leave.
Take it back to Atlanta.
And then, and hey, y'all keep lying, we're gonna come shut y'all down in Atlanta too. And that's real.
We got people in Atlanta.
We got people in Atlanta storm all through that building and shut y'all down. Just like we're shutting down Walmart. We're gonna take on Walmart, we're taking on y'all too. So don't even think that we won't. Yeah.
We're shutting down movies.
Don't even think that we won't.
Show the Mike Brown video of Darren Wilson standing over Mike Brown's body. There's no blood.
Publish a fucking timeline of his death.
Y'all demonized and convicted Mike Brown before y'all ever even released
him. He might have been a lead now.
I'm loud as shit. She might have been able to. She might have been able to tune Bass him out, but I'm loud as fuck. Sorry, but I'm not sorry.
Okay, MDK got shut down.
Okay, see there.
That's that story.
That boopy.
See, and then I'm sorry. He'll film it.
You do a check-in?
We did that in Anaheim. They were trying to lie, Channel 7. It was like the best way you shut down a live broadcast is jump right in their screen and go, shit, fuck, damn, I don't give a fuck, immediately. Can't say shit. Whatever.
Yeah, as soon as they went live, we went, damn, bitch, what the fuck you gonna do?
Lying.
Live.
Lying.
You fake. So gone. And everybody knows it.
Does anybody get the significance of this coolie cup that I have in my hand?
Man,
elbow. Does anybody get the significance of
that? That swish of sweets, Mike Brown.
That's awesome, Doug. I ain't gonna stunt. That's the highlight of my night.
They said she was cringing. They said that we could hear my voice on CNN hella clear.
Yes.
Hi. I just had a little bit of streamer fun. We just shut down CNN. They packed up and left.
Yeah.
Freedom fighters just about that. Man, I'm just saying, they lied, man. I was watching from California, and I was mad as fuck because they was lying. So, like, why are you here? If y'all want to know what's happening in Ferguson, then you can contact people on fucking Twitter. You can watch the live streams. If you don't know who they are, watch the live stream. Even if you don't fucking like me, say, hey, Bella, who is that you talking to? I want to talk to them, and I will get you their contact info. You don't even have to fucking like me. But if you want the truth, then you got to investigate yourself. They're going to lie. Thus, you're gonna get my perspective on my stream.
Bullshit. I'm like, I'm tired of the bullshit. I'm done with the bullshit. Turn it off. I can't watch it. It's just nothing but bullshit.
Hello. I'm good. I just had a little fun. That was fun.
You ain't sacrificing your life. You're not sacrificing your life. You don't understand the struggle that we've been through. 72 days of this, you gonna come out here just because a senator got arrested? Get out my face.
She called.
Oh, we wanted to talk to the police that arrested her. What if I get arrested? You coming? Or are you coming?
Absolutely not.
Because you been out her. Because you ain't coming.
Out her.
That's what I know.
Hey, Ray, you don't have a chief of staff. Maybe she can't call them out here.
She got lawyers, chief of staff. She can call the governor if she want to get her shit lifted. Don't you jerk.
Yeah.
Y'all want to come out here. A senator was arrested in Ferguson.
I didn't get the email, fire fam. If you could resend it, that would be great. I'm sorry.
A senator was arrested in Ferguson last night. And the protesters did not allow us to show the media coverage. They said that we're lying. They were acting very savage.
No. You can hear us on CNN before they shut it down. You can hear us yelling into the mic. That's what they going. Bella, you can hear your voice loud and clear on CNN.
Keep coming back.
That's good.
Then they shut her down.
I am beyond the point of trying to be understanding to people who do not understand why we are here. You don't even know the true mission no more.
They said
you don't even know why you here. You don't even remember that boy's name. His name. 4.5 hours, 72 days. Talk about it. You don't know his name. You want to come out here and get in front of these cameras and you don't remember his name. The ground over him ain't even settled yet.
Come on.
He don't even got a motherfucking tombstone. And you still out here trying to take advantage of this? Fuck you.
And criminalizing him as a victim.
Exactly.
Only in America can the victim be criminalized when he's black. Then it's like, oh, let's talk about the person who didn't have a gun and how he wasn't shit and he was a thug and let me continue to perpetuate the stereotype so you will forgive the abuses.
Tell me that you got more. You got clout. Fuck your clout. I'll put you there and I'll take you out. Like, nobody care about
they said they're on CNN nobody apologizing for technical people. Difficulties.
Your mother is still mourning. Your bitch's mother is still mourning. A cop is still free. You want to lock a senator up? Fine. You can take her to jail. Take Darren Wilson with her. I'm not worried about that no more. I don't care about it. We know what we out here doing. She knew when she came out here, she wanted to get locked up. Don't advocate for her because she got a voice. Advocate for the voiceless. Advocate for those who have been killed. Advocate for those who cannot speak on their own.
Freeze.
Use your voice for good. Freeze. Don't you dare come out here to use his name for nothing above your own. Don't you dare do it. Because I will shut you down every time. Mark my name. Put it on it. Caleb Reed, I do not have a problem. I will give up my life for this. You will not do that. You're not going to do it. Let me see you again, and I'm going to shut you down again.
Every time.
You're not welcome in Ferguson if you're not here for Mike.
Nope. Real talk.
You want to be an alderman, go to Shaw. You want to be a city senator, go to Shaw.
That's the thing, though. They're not even from here. That's not even their area. You know what I'm saying?
They're not here.
Come on, bro. They supposed to be in the city. Like two niggas that get killed in the city the other night. You know what I'm saying? But you out here putting on this show, like, bro, we not stupid. You know what I'm saying? Like,
it's shut it down.
I can't get a cop locked up, but I can get every black senator arrested.
You hear me?
Every I can't get a
senator.
Cop locked up.
Every
you
want to
worry
senator.
About your reputation, worry about the legacy we building for that little boy. That's a boy when you 18 and you get shot down. There's no reason that we had to see that. There's no reason that 72 days we didn't have to go get prepped for winter protesting. This shouldn't be happening. But because it is, I'm going to damn make sure you're not going to take advantage of
absolutely
it.
Not.
You're not going to capitalize on my
strength. The fact they're going to come out here, they came out here knowing that we know that
there's no indictment is going to be here in days. You know what I'm saying? That's why we emotional. The fact that we know they had already told people that, you know, there's no indictment is happening real soon. They already making plans for kids at school and all this good stuff like that. So, yes, we're emotional. And if we know it, these politicians know it. So knowing that, why are you coming out here to try to take attention from the real issues? We don't care nothing about what's happening in November. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, at the end of the day, that's not gonna affect what's happening right now.
They you said CNN saying? Is now spreading pro-Wilson propaganda because we ran them away.
Well, so
they
who cares?
This is for you,
CNN. Who cares, bro?
For all
they was going to do that anyway.
It was already loaded.
Darren Wilson propaganda. You know what I'm saying?
The media has been putting out Darren Wilson propaganda.
We did the right thing by putting our ass out.
Propaganda.
Anybody can get it, man. Right now, we just feeling like enough is enough. Y'all can have them games. Y'all can have this show. Y'all can have these smoking these mirrors and all that. It's possible that niggas is about to die in these streets and you out here playing. You out here playing. This is not a game for us. We can't come out here and put on a show for people and soft shoe or whatever for votes. No, nigga, this is our real life. These are real kids. These are real brothers and our real cousins getting killed by the police every day. No, it's not a game. It's killer for everybody. Any politician, you come out here
on that
extra,
anything.
On that
bullshit.
We shutting it down. Yeah. We shutting it down.
You can have a collar around your neck and preach to God himself. You can be a politician. You can be a business owner. You can anything that you got a platform on. If you use that platform to further your platform, instead of using it to push this cause, you are not welcome here.
Yeah.
And I mean that. 72 days I done been out here, and I come out every fucking day to shut you down.
Yeah, we gonna keep shutting them down.
Shut all these games, man.
I'm turning off the stream right now.
Darren Wilson not even gonna get a. Like, it's looking like he's not even gonna get. You worried about a senator? She knows the legal job is to protect the Constitution.
Listen, make sure
she knows what she's doing.
Listen,
she's a senator.
She called. They already knew she had a reservation to get arrested.
She had a reservation.
You know what I'm saying? It's not nobody. She came out here.
Y'all can arrest me if I come out tonight.
Yes.
Yeah, we got you, Jamilah. Okay, I'm coming.
So why is she in the fire department? In the firehouse. The jail is over here.
She ain't even been transported yet. Let's look at statistics.
That's what I'm saying.
Did I ever get a clergy visit before I got shipped off to say that? Did anybody ever come in to talk on my behalf before I got put in paper?
They're not going to.
Absolutely not.
Because you don't have constituents.
I'm done.
You don't have a chief of staff.
You don't have constituents. So
you got nobody to come talk on your behalf? No, we're not going to let you get no media time. You want to get locked up? Get locked up like a real person. Get locked up.
And nobody cares.
Get carried away.
Get locked up and have it. Nobody give a fuck.
That's how the process works. Get locked up and have nobody come. You don't get arrested like a regular fucking person out here.
We had a little time.
We're not gonna put you on no cross and call you no martyr. That's what we're not gonna do.
Mike Brown is the martyr. Mike Brown is the martyr. You know what I'm saying? That's who we need to
be. I was only here because I was watching them live.
But everybody just talking about everything but Mike Brown. Everything but Darren Wilson about to just walk. It's time out. Jack, man, it's too late in the game.
Jackson was coming to the press conference prayers. It was hashtag press conference prayers. We had never seen them shit like that. Like, oh, we don't pray before we do. Okay. So we're watching live. And then CNN do a broadcast. And they were blowing the fuck out of the
CNN just said Mike Brown.
I just watched the protest live, and all I saw was drums.
And you should see somebody that's close.
When you think why is it that story
is important, Darren Wilson?
I'm just like, okay.
What sound bite you here to get tonight? Basim had already started. I was like, I'm trying to be good, y'all. Basim was already in, and I just kept saying, in Anaheim, you know, we just was like, fuck shit ass, damn bitch. And then it just happened. It just kind of happened after that. And I'm loud as fuck. You're not going to be able to, like, hide that mic nowhere. They're picking you up and got me.
Screaming at it. But CNN does that all the time.
They do it all the time.
You know, they'll find out what suits them.
They can make it up. They can make the evidence.
Blood in the car. Blood on this cat uniform. It confirms what Dorian said. That's what it to me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Anybody that's not racist would believe that shit.
Real talk.
Because it makes sense.
Real talk. If you
that's
say
reasonable.
You,
if that's you, tell, me,
you tell me you support Darren Wilson, all I'm hearing you say you're a lunatic racist. Point blank, period.
They saying I should clip this and give it to CNN's rival.
Yeah, clip it and give it to their rival. Damn right, dude.
We should.
Hell yeah, we should.
We should clip that and give it to CNN's rival.
I just archived
it. Let's kill it for them, too.
I just archived it.
Let's get it for them, too. I don't need that.
I'm saying
right, she said, who is CNN's rival? Fox? Fuck that.
Yeah. Hold on. Who's gonna call next?
Let me tell you why.
No, not gonna happen.
They got run off. The grand jury testimony is supposed to be private. The story we get is that the federal investigation is privy to the grand jury that's supposed to be private.
Right.
Over the weekend, we look up and see it in the New York Times on the front page. The stress level went from here to here because that's supposed to be private, and we see them breaking the rules that they created. And people are upset and people are bothered because they see the unfairness, they see the fix, and it's already in. They're trying to precondition us to accept the fact that this guy is going to walk. And they're leaking private grand jury.
You mean they trying to precondition the rest of America who didn't already know that?
Well, yeah. good point.
I'm like, we already knew that.
Everybody already knew that.
I said a lot. People are like, what do the protesters want? I said, really what it is they just want to remind y'all that we already know what's happening. We just waiting on you to prove us right.
Yeah, and they take us through this song and dance.
Like we've been saying.
To pretend as though justice is going to, you know, be served in a fair and impartial way. And everybody knew from the outset that this was fixed. And so the reason that you see these people running CNN off today is because they're offended when they come around here and act like this thing's not fixed and they know what's about to happen. And so you got tensions running high among people who really care about this because their lives are on the line, you know. You know, and that's what's happening out here. You know, it's not people just going crazy and hollering and screaming at news media for nothing. It's because people already know what's about to transpire. And we already know it's fixed. And everybody already knows that it's a great big lie. And it's a great big song and dance.
Yeah.
And we don't respect it.
Nah.
We don't respect it
they
at all.
They think it's a game.
They think it's a joke.
For real.
Nobody respects it. You know, and anybody with a reasonable mind and with any kind of human capacity for understanding and, you know, any inertia for goodness in their heart would look at this situation and go, this is a slam dunk case.
Yeah.
It's open and shut. He murdered that kid. There's no way on earth that you can look
at this. Well, that's not, but see, that's what I'm saying. You're going too far.
Yeah.
Like, the indictment is merely charges. That's why the chant goes indict, then convict, right? Because we are still in the charges. We're saying charge him with what is an undisputable fact,
okay,
that we already know he did that. Right. We know this.
Right.
So really, like, this postponement of the indictment already lets you know that there is no justice, because that should have been something that just happened. Like, oh, he shot him. Right, exactly. Like, oh, he shot him. Now he's indicted. Now we protesting because you're not convicting him. You see what I'm saying? Like, that's what the protest should honestly be about. But we still on the fucking indictment. We just saying charging for shit we already know. We haven't even gotten to the conviction. So why are you considering all this extra evidence? We're not asking you if he's guilty or innocent. We're asking you, did he shoot him, charge him with that. Now let's work on evidence. Like, you are trying to surpass due process for this individual by the shady, underhanded tactics that you are using with your protocol. You see what I mean? Like, we should have already fucking indicted him because he did it. He said he did it. He confessed. Indict him. Let's get to the trial. Like, right, let's get to that.
Right.
We not even, we 70 something fucking days in,
right,
and we are not at trial, right, which leads me to say that no matter what trial comes after this, unless it's by fire, it is not fair.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
Right, right, right.
Because if we are depending on the same abusive system that condones this excessive force of the police department to tell people to stay on the sidewalk the same way that they would condone an actual fucking riot at Pumpkin Fest where cars are being flipped over.
Cool.
Like, dude, you know what I'm saying? They're letting you know that this system does not represent justice for a vast majority of the black community. You know what I'm saying?
And a vast majority of the poor and working.
Yeah. Let's not get it twisted. Yeah. I'm only putting the race analysis on it because a white officer and a black police officer.
Right.
I am from Occupy. I definitely am. I believe that classism was also used to keep us segregated. I think that isolation is the worst thing that we could possibly have as poor and people of color, because the worst fear,
mm-hmm,
was for us to come together as a whole to topple this system that profits over us. So I'm not saying that, you know, it doesn't go, it doesn't cross color lines. I'm definitely not saying that.
Yeah,
I'm just saying that,
things,
right, in a city where the police department is 90-something percent white and the city is fucking damn near 80-something percent black, it's funny that you seem to find a whole bunch of free black officers to come address the crowd when there's cameras in your face. You know what I mean? Like, there's definitely an undertone of racial issues here where white privilege is heightened as a way to keep us segregated from those who live in lower socioeconomic conditions but are our brothers and sisters of the other complexion. You see,
okay,
what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
So I'm like, I think that we need to pay attention to it only so that we can break that barrier down and get to know one another, understand our experiences, and uplift one another to start to combat the system that oppresses us all.
Oh.
That's my big position. But see, a lot of trolls like to cut me off right before I finish that last part and be like, Bella's a fucking racist.
I worry about no,
right, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. But they like, Bella's a fucking racist, and that's not true.
But you know what, Bella? This goes back years and years, and you know, people kind of get upset when you talk about what's happened in the past, but the housing patterns in this country were mandated by law to keep people segregated. Not only the housing, but the police departments have been used for years and years and years and years. And that's where a lot of this anger comes.
Are we going to act like the police department was not originally the KKK?
You know what I'm saying? To pull people over, get them involved in that court system.
Hold on. Are we going to act in a slave state where y'all used to sell slaves on the same courthouse steps that we got to go to for political court dates, right? Okay. That the KKK were not the police department? Are we going to act like that? Are we going to act like that? Because I'm just saying.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, that might be less of a serious fucking argument in California, although I don't believe it, but like here, it's a vibe that you just get getting off the plane.
Oh, or
you know you come in, like, it just, you feel it. It's fucked up, but you feel it.
You know what Dick Gregory said?
Hmm.
He said, racism is not a color, it's an attitude.
No, for real.
That sums it up.
No, for
it's
real.
It's an attitude.
It is an attitude.
Supremacy.
No, it is.
You know what I mean? And it goes beyond, like you're saying, you know, you can sense the attitude of white supremacy when you step off of the plane. It's just an attitude.
It's crazy.
You know, and not all white people are white supremacists.
No.
But, you know, you've got a select group of people who are in power, and typically they're the powerful business people who control the... Did you know in St. Louis there's a group called Civic Progress? It's 12 people who run this city. They run it up and down. Nothing happens business-wise
City of St. Louis without civic progress. Now, do your research, internet. Check out who Civic Progress is. They're the most powerful business people in the city of St. Louis. And this city does not move. When that Keel House was supposed to be renovated, it didn't move until it sat there for damn near a decade until Civic Progress says, move. It didn't move. And that's the way the city operates. It doesn't move without those powerful businessmen giving their okay.
We have the Business Commerce. What's the fuck the name of that group? I don't know, because they don't represent shit that I'm talking about. That's right, why I can't remember.
Right.
Chamber of Commerce. Business Commerce people.
Chamber of Commerce.
Chamber of Commerce. Thank okay. you. I can't okay. even think of it. I'm sorry. I'm tired. I'm like, who the fuck? Okay, but anyway, we have them. They always talk about like what the businesses in Oakland need, but you're not talking about the mom and pop businesses of Oakland. You're talking about the Pete's Coffee, the Walgreens, the Rite Aid, all the chain establishments that really profit off of the criminalization of the youth, not the mom and pop whose son go to the high school down the street.
Yeah.
Who might, you know what I mean? Like, you're not talking about them. And so it bothers me because an Oakland, like, we were even listed as, like, along with Paris and shit, like, one of the places to visit because of our underground, like, food spots. Mm-hmm. But a lot of these hole-in-the-wall food spots are mom and pops.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, they are families struggling to make a living. But you're not talking about their issues when you come into the city council and talk about it. Because a lot of them come out and say how they support the protests because the protesters support them, and they're highlighting a lot more of the issues that have to do with them and their businesses.
Absolutely.
And so I'm like, when you talk about these 12 people on the, what is it, the Civic Progress. The Civic Progress Committee. It makes me think of a way that even if you are a person of color in a city like this, that you can be in such an authoritative position that it might even blind you to what, like, you should actually be doing as a representative for people in the community. Because you start to appease your colleagues so things would be made easier for you and your career would be solidified versus, like, me actually taking the risk and throwing my body on the gears as a representative of people who have had a muted voice for far too long. You know what I mean? So.
And you know what? In the city of Ferguson, the mom and pop businesses are not the problem. There's beautiful people who built businesses up and down Flores and Row here. A man named Joe Lanero, he owns a tons of businesses up and down this block right here. Everybody in the community loves him. They love his son. They love that family because that family worked really hard to establish small businesses in this area, you know, in this city, to try and help the city, you know, and he doesn't have a racist bone in his body. So we're really not talking about the small businesses in Ferguson. What we're talking about is a larger infrastructure of racism that's built around them. Because those people, you know, really have made positive contributions to the city. And they're not the problem. You know what I mean? They're really not the problem. That's not who this protest is about.
Right.
This protest is about the structural racism where people get pulled over and, you know, and they get sucked into this court system, not just in Ferguson, but in Florissant and, you know, in Country Club Hills and Jennings and all these little small municipalities. And on the backs of poor people, these municipalities make a quarter of their income off of tickets and bench warrants. And, you know, people get caught up in that whole bench warrant system and they break good people, you know. Poor people who are struggling, just trying to survive.
That's what I was talking about, the poor tax. Like, poor people shouldn't have to go to jail for certain crimes because you're going to jail simply because you don't have money.
Nonviolent offense.
Exactly. It's like these are victimless crimes.
We're not
I don't have any money. And like, what if I didn't have money to get my seatbelt fixed, but I needed to get back and forth to work, and that's the only way I'm providing for my family? Like, you can't give me a ticket and put me in jail and make me lose my job when I'm simply trying to, trust me, that getting my seatbelt fixed is a priority because I know you will give me a ticket for this.
Right.
Shit.
That's right.
Like, it's like I'm trapped in the financial, it's like economic trap.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And this is where I say that it's just like looking at it through the race lens of analysis. It's like, for this economic trap, as a black person, I'll have four officers who are ready to pull out their guns on me versus the one officer or one or two just because of like protocol and backup, right? But once you see that it's a white person, you know what I mean? You're instantly more at ease. Or like when it's me and my white friends, you pull them out the car to make sure that I'm not kidnapping them or some shit like that. And that literally happened with me and Nick and him on the way down here. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm like, it's not that I'm being racist. I'm talking about my experiences of white supremacy in my life and how that shit has like completely blown my mind. Because I'm supposed to, like, didn't Martin Luther King and Malcolm X and him happen already? Like, didn't Rosa Parks, didn't they do that? You know what I'm saying? Like, honestly,
we thought they did.
So I'm like, when these things happen every single time, even though I know it's a reality, because day after day I deal with the subtle nuances of racism in my life, like, it fucking blows my whole entire mind. So then when I shout about it passionately, it's people who are blinded to that or do not want to accept the reality, especially because it's not their reality, and that's where that white privilege lies, that you don't have to accept it as your reality. You could literally call me an ignorant monkey, turn around, completely ignore me, and this shit will never affect you. You know what I mean? But, like, so that's where I'm saying that this is a problem, and it is a human issue, because you need to realize that I am a human, and I deserve to walk down the street and not be criminalized just as much as you. Maybe my kid got a mental health issue too. It's not just a white boy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, maybe I'm a single mom and I'm struggling the best I can, and maybe I'm a single mom not because his father is a fucking drug addict, gang bang banger, jail, whatever. You know what I mean? Like, do not stereotype me in these things. I have the same problems as many white women, as Asian women, as Hispanic women across the world, not just the U.S. So treat me like a human that needs food, water, clothing, and shelter to survive, that will have offspring that need milk first and then learn to eat and walk and talk. You know what I mean? Like, that is all we're asking for. When my son is walking down the street, if he did commit a crime, arrest him. Right. Allow him the due process that we are supposedly provided in this country as American citizens. Do not shoot to kill him. Right. You know what I mean? Like, fuck. Absolutely. Shoot him in his pinky toe. You know what I mean? Like, if you had to.
Shoot him in the kneecap.
Like I'm saying, anything. At this point, you know, and you know what? And the shameful part is, us saying that are cries of desperation.
Absolutely.
The truth of the matter is, do not fucking shoot us.
Yeah.
We are all not criminals. We are all not armed.
Right.
You know what I mean? We are all not militant minded or even political.
And many of us are educated people.
Exactly.
And we're disappointed in America. We are completely disappointed in what we're getting. You know, we got that whole I have a dream thing. We lived by that. When we were kids, you know, coming up in school, our parents taught us to reach for the sky, and we went through school and matriculated with positive attitudes, and we went and got our college degrees, and when we got out, guess what happened? The nation was sicker than it was when we were kids.
Right.
And we're disappointed. We're like, you know, it was like when I went to college, you know, right around the time I was going to college, I was senior in high school, and I told my mom, I want to go to UCLA. And she was like, are you crazy? UCLA? Our family don't have that kind of money. I was like, what are you talking about? Did my dad put a college fund behind me? You know, did he put some money aside for me to go to college? She was like, yeah, whatever.
Right.
And I was genuinely shocked.
That didn't happen.
I was genuinely shocked. And it's that same kind of shock that people experience when they grow up and believe that America's gonna give us our best. It's gonna give, you know, us its best when we give our best. And we give our best and we come to the end of the road and we go, are you really this racist? You gotta be kidding me.
But you know what? Across lines, like, one of the five top lies of our generation is that if you go to college, you'll get a good job and be able to take care of yourself. I literally know engineers who work at Costco as cashiers. You know what I mean? Like, and then they're bogged down with home payments and home loans and student loans and... And everything else, you know what I mean? Like, it's one of the biggest lies, but we simply don't invest into our community the way that we need to be able to provide even jobs, like to be able for people to provide livelihoods for themselves, even if they're working as hard as they possibly can. Like, we just don't do that. But it's more inherent in Black communities, because all of the unemployed engineers I know are Black.
And we're wasting so much talent.
Man.
We're wasting talent.
I got a ringtone just based off the drum and the chants out here. It's organic talent out here.
Absolutely.
That is oppressed.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, if a church needed some parishioners to be leaders, why don't you come out here to the protest? You got leaders all over the place. Yeah, there's some of them rough around the edges. But my God, they've ignited the whole world with this protest. You mean, and our churches need leaders. Our mosques need leaders. You know, you know what I mean? We're wasting talent.
We're wasting a lot of things.
Wasting a lot of talent.
This is what gotta get the crowd. Thank you.
I'm glad you're welcome.
This is what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
He said you need your own show. This guy needs his own show.
Is you tell us my show?
Come in, send that killer cops to jail. The whole damn system.
I don't know. Let me see. So you guys, that's the senator that was arrested. Thank you.
The whole damn system is guilty as hell.
I said the whole damn system
is guilty as hell.
I said the whole damn system
is guilty as hell.
And if we don't get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
If Mike 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 don't get it,
shut it down.
They say move back. We say fight back.
Fight back.
They say move back. We say fight back.
Fight back.
Move back. Lord. Kayla, what's the...
I'm just really
emotional. Oh. Back up.
Hey, y'all need to donate a drum to Lost Voices. Everybody, each group, 3 drums. 1 for Freedom Fighters, 1 for Lost Voices, and 1 for Tribeck. They need drums. They need backup drums for when the police come try to take them. Y'all got to help them keep this morale and energy up.
These cops ain't got to go.
It's like a 73 days, y'all. It's 73 fucking days. The stream has been up for 41 minutes and 40 seconds. We'll not be shutting down for another hour and 15 minutes.
United we stand.
Divided we fall. Divided we fall.
Divided we fall.
Divided we fall.
Divided we fall.
Divided we fall.
Hands up.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to win.
It is our duty to win.
We must love and support each other.
We must love and support each other. We have nothing to lose but our chains.
It's our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to win.
We must love and support each other.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to win.
It is our duty to win. We must love and support each other. We have nothing to lose but our chains. I don't care. That's beautiful, and I will participate in it as many times as I want, and I can still call myself a journalist. It's beautiful. I'm just sorry. It's the same amendment that protects journalists' rights, that protects their right to protest. How can I not be out here? How can you tell me that I got to be out here and I cannot participate? How is that even possible? Hey, y'all, so this might be a good time to let you know that
we gonna fight all day and night until we get
hey.
What side are you on, my people? What side are you on?
I'm on the freedom side.
What side are you on, my people? What side are you on?
We on the freedom side.
Mike Brown was a freedom fighter. He showed us how to fight. We gonna fight all day and night until we get it right. What side are you on, my people? What side are you on?
We on the freedom side.
You
went and checked on this?
Harriet Tubman was a freedom fighter.
You keep that up.
Okay, that is him. I didn't know if it was him, so I didn't say nothing.
What side are you on, my people? What side are you on? We are the freedom side.
It's not that they never heard of advocacy journalism or gonzo journalism, Courtney. It's selective enforcement, you know, much like the police they support. Anyway, so I've been having to rent a car to transport myself because the night I was detained, I was left in Shaw at 4 a.m. and had to find a ride. And so ever since then, I've been less dependent upon people to get me to and from the protest. And so the rental cars are fairly expensive. It's been about $200, $250 for a week. So I know that that's like a crazy expense, but I don't have to worry about housing, so I'm not worried about a hotel. So if you guys could donate to me to help me out with that additional expense, that'd be great. It definitely does help me get to and from, and it helps me to, you know, get the baby situated so I can make it to protests to document. Well, the protests are getting smaller because this weekend was the Ferguson October weekend. There were thousands of people from various parts of the country who came down in support. So you see that thinning out because people have started to go home. But you see that the parking lot is full. People are in their cars. People are outside with blankets. The wintertime is picking up and the weather is, the temperatures are dropping. So there are still people here. They're in the parking lots maintaining space, but not everybody is always standing outside.
Let me know about it. I know that the OBS is doing some stuff here at 1:30.
Fire fam, I have babysitters down here. I just don't want to leave my baby with everybody, so I can't always, you know, drop them off and run to the protest, but I do try to keep a schedule. I have a few different people who have agreed to watch him for me. It's all about balancing that out. These are people who I have already known or who have come very highly recommended to me because they have already watched other people's children. That's no different from any other babysitting scenario where, you know, a single mother has to find a babysitter to watch their child when they go to work. I come document instead of a 9-to-5, so I have non-traditional hours, which also causes it to be slightly difficult. But I have managed to work something out. I just need help making sure that I can keep the transportation. You know, I definitely be try to be responsible with my contributions. I have not been spending my money excessively on anything. I've definitely been relying on family and community for a lot of the things that I need, and also some of my own finances. But with your support, I am able to continue to be here and to continue to document. And hopefully I will not have to go home until after the indictment or a decision has been made. And if things kick up after that, hopefully I won't have to leave until this entire thing has been documented efficiently. Willie Washington, all I see is that war. Where'd it go? I don't know. It says something about war. It said something, but it cut off. The PayPal button is on my website. It's vemedia.weebly.com/donations. There's a PayPal button. But if you donate using my email, which is bellaeiko bellaeikomedia at me.com, if you donate using that and delegate it as a gift, I will receive the whole amount versus having increments taken out for tax purposes, I guess. But I am not a 501c3. I do not have a 501c3 status, so any donation made to me will not be tax deductible. I think I might have briefly met with somebody from MSNBC, but she was a freelancer. And that was a few, maybe 5 days ago or so, inside the subway when the media vans first started showing up and the MSNBC Streamline showed up. Are you kidding me? There's Ebola everywhere. Aren't you familiar with the black scare? We got the Ebola disease gonna come from Africa. And then we all thugs and killers. And then they got, you know, the police got shot by a robbery.
You should be more concerned that a cop can kill a black person in this country and not get indicted than you should be of some punk ass virus. Deal with it. It's a cure for Ebola already. Ain't no cure for being black in America.
There's no care for that. Oh, okay. That's awesome that they're doing that. He's on paid vacation, though. He doesn't really need any money. Can people please post my email in the chat stream, please? Any of the mods?
One damn person. Motherfucker still talking about
ISIS.
Nigga, what?
Mr. Boogie, man. I don't even believe ISIS is real.
ISIS is here. Oh, ISIS was here like August 8th. ISIS don't know shit about no person.
But I'm sorry, but the police have killed more American citizens than ISIS ever has.
And Ebola. ISIS and Ebola. The police killed more people.
I'm like, if Ebola was such a threat, when where's the CDC protocol to stop these goddamn flights?
The other day, wait a minute. So with that Ebola shit the other day, you know how they had that person on the news outside the plane, they're like, oh my God, they don't have one that has a gear, blah, blah. That's because they know some shit. It wasn't no slip up or he was breaking the rules. No, he knows some shit because Ebola is some bullshit. It's a scare tactic.
It's another thing to program you to say something else from Africa gonna kill you. These niggas gonna kill you. They got enough right, black. That's what I'm saying. This is
people every day.
Fear mongering has been a tool of our media and government since forever.
Media, government, everybody.
Hey, Jake, that car made it from the south side. Fuck that car up last couple months ago.
What you mean, all the new people?
And fuck Darren Wilson, bitch ass.
Hey, watch your mouth, child. Sometimes you forget. Yeah, sometimes you forget. Like, okay, you just
get
me. I ain't never forgot.
Don't
shut your ass up.
Your motherfucker's crazy as shit. Courtney is here. Rise is also here. My mods are doing the best that they can. The trolls come out like cockroaches when I start filming and stuff. You know what I mean? So you got to give my mods a little bit of time, but they're definitely getting the job done. I believe in one night, one of my mods did 65, all of them on his own, banned 65 trolls, and that's not including the other three or four mods that I had. So, like, y'all got to be a little patient. I'm there on the, they're on it. It's whack-a-troll instead of whack-a-mole. It's going down.
I fucking hate them. Like, again, did anybody see this trailer?
Which one?
My grandma. Huh?
I beg your pardon?
Yeah, you
I can't be with no man that can't stand up for them.
Right. Hello. Right.
For real.
You be like, excuse me, what you
say? Right. It's like when a white person use niggas.
Wait, hold on. I don't think you I heard you right. And then, then you go in a circle, then you be like, dog, I know you didn't just, I know.
Wait, hold on.
No, you just got to throw the hand up.
Right, dog, I know.
Hold on.
Dog, I know.
You hit him with the face, bro.
What's WAAR radio?
You
got to talk
to him. You be like, bro, I know you didn't just call me a nigga, dog.
No. Hold on. Opposing views are not trolls. You are correct. Opposing views are not trolls. What I'm saying is the people who get on here and say all you niggers are on food stamps and welfare and get a fucking job and you porch monkeys and this is a chipmunk. Oh, yeah, I get hate email.
No, hate mail.
No, I know. They actually found you to do that.
How could you? Why would you? Come on, man. Everybody has the right to their own opinion. Why waste all your time sending me hate mail? Seriously.
Fuzzits, thank you, Fuzzits.
You have nothing else to
you have nothing else to do, okay? I'm going to take my time to hate this person and send them I love Darren Wilson or a box of comments or some job application. Get you a life. Obviously, you don't have a life. And you have the time to.
Hands up, don't shoot.
Hey, Freedom Fighter, how you doing?
Hey, Lost Voice. Found Voice, right?
Found Voice. I'm still the founder of Lost Voice.
WAAR Radio's donating $100,000 to Darren Wilson because he's on paid vacation. He completely needs that money. What the fuck? That shit kills me. Like, what the fuck?
Hey, is you watching people commenting?
Yeah, people are talking to me. I got 409 people watching right now.
What about y'all? I
keep trying to tell people that we need drums. We need each group to fucking get a donated drum. So if the police come to try to take it, just fuck it. Get another one. Like, we need that to keep up the energy and the morale. Shit. That's awesome.
The police be on some straight bullshit. Though.
Yeah, but the freedom
and
of speech.
And the media do too. I'm tired of the media. Like, I'm so fed.
I wish you was here earlier. That was so fun.
Yeah.
CNN is mad at us.
I've never been that fed up. I'm so fed up with them. Like, super fed. Watching the news and seeing what happened at the Rams game yesterday and then, like, seeing everything on Twitter. You're like, okay, are you serious? Like, get the story right. Y'all could at least interview at least one protester. Or how about, there you go. That's the perfect word for it. The lies. Yeah, that's what I'm
thank you, Govay, Govay. You said make that 408.
Hey.
Hey, Lost Voices.
What's up, world?
He said, what's up, world? Hey, Michael's crazy with the trolls, y'all. Y'all better be careful. You get kicked out. Once Michael bans you, I have nothing to do with it. It's just that's happened. Jay Fun is a no three troll. Well, whatever. Well, y'all, you can see, hey, I'm short, but let me see. I don't think I can get up here. I think I'll just embarrass myself. So I'm gonna go like this. Hey, get a big shot, a tall shot. Everybody's for me, please. AJ gonna get an aerial shot for y'all.
Oh, you did it yourself? Okay, that's what I'm talking about.
On the ramp? I just want to get a span of like a crowd from the top, so I'm not sure.
Like on Saturdays.
So if I walk over here, walk with me. Oh, sorry. I just want to see.
Like I was like texting with her, like more than that.
Oops, sorry. Oh, it's just a few police officers. They getting tired of sitting in the firehouse. They probably coming outside to take a smoke. It was probably more than that, but they right there. I'm sorry, y'all. It was right there. When I'm not taking all my extra money and putting it into streaming, I go to the nail shop. I ain't did that. Right? I'm like, protest life is different. My expenses change.
I haven't been to the nail shop in 3 months.
Look, she's like, hold on, let me look. 3 months.
But no.
Right.
I'm not used to that.
Okay.
Something happens, some type of pamper to yourself. Like, man. My account set up now. No, I like the way it's set up, all you can do is needs, not wants. That's all. Brother can do needs now. You scratch. Okay, hold up. Let me figure out how I'm going to do this.
Black feminist. Well, Michael, I'm sure you see the one that has to go now, right?
So, can you tell me what happened at the end of the Occupy suit?
It was good. It was good. Nothing really happened. We just...
I got it.
Plus, I left a little early.
I got it.
So, because I had heard that that the women were kind of left out of the negotiations.
I'll walk away.
That's right.
Can't get that on straight.
I understand. Okay. I'm like, I'm free.
Right for referees, it's not paying. I did one the other day. I got a great
spot. And it was like, right, that's, and it was when the decision that was made by the
judge.
Which I, at this point, the most important thing is that y'all figure out the
thing. It was basically my way of telling my bosses that I've been up to.
I mean, everybody gotta make their own individual decisions.
I know. I have a lot of work ahead when I go home.
Y'all gotta find a way. You know what I mean? Like, find a way. I already talked to them too.
See, I'm having trouble over here with the Wi-Fi. I need to go over there. As soon as I go home,
I'm just hoping that it doesn't break apart. So it's like right now, I can't even stay here with shit, like, you know. But right now, it's still some shit going on in Oakland where we're trying to keep the last remaining group that didn't fall apart from falling apart. I'm like, y'all need to keep from falling apart so y'all can fucking come out here. Stop. Stop it. Stop. It's been 3 years. Y'all still on that bullshit. When we literally kept going so much that you can go Google the shit. We had a police officers that started to kill themselves. And they weren't kidding. Quitting their job. They were fucking killing themselves. We were literally winning. We was literally winning. But we couldn't stop fighting each other. You know what I'm saying? Like, the bigger picture, we was getting it done, but the internal shit was fucking up. So that's why I'm like, please don't do what we did. You know what I mean? Like, that's where it is. It's like, please don't do what we did. I'm willing to admit that we fucked up and made hella mistakes. If that'll keep y'all from doing the same shit. Because what y'all got going on is so fucking powerful that I really did leave my job. And I really did leave my mother and my house out there. And I'm out here with my baby. And I want more people to do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, fuck that. But you know what? It was the live streams of seeing y'all every night that got me out here. You know what I mean? And so it's gonna be the live stream. Seeing y'all not giving up, relentless, you know, not being unafraid, you know what I'm saying? Educating yourselves. That's the shit that gets everybody to keep coming. And eventually the blinders will have to come on. You know what I mean? But unfortunately, like, some people are gonna be able to be dumb longer than you can take it. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's a way to find, you gotta find a way to make shit work here, but you also gotta find a way to diversity attack it so y'all don't fucking go crazy out here all the time. There's other shit y'all can do. Y'all know I'm standing here to help y'all with that. Yeah. Hold on, I'm about to go unmute y'all. All right, sorry, y'all. Y'all know I'm not just out here recording. I'm out here networking and building a community. So there are oftentimes conversations that don't need to be streamed for everybody. Although I am about presenting the truth, you also have to give protesters the right to strategize. You have to give them the element of surprise because they don't have much else all the time.
Fuck Chief Jackson, bitch ass. Fuck Barack Obama, bitch ass. Fuck Michelle Obama, bitch ass.
Y'all in our community.
Fuck Lil Wayne. Fuck
There's
Drake.
A rapper named Low Key who says damn near the same right shit out. You said. And it's my favorite song, and it's called Abomination Abomination Part 2.
Niggas not helping us for real.
Yeah.
Fuck you. If you ain't from Mike Brown, fuck you. And all you bitch ass trolls out there, get the fuck off my Twitter page, bitch. Die quick.
Get fuck you trolls though. I agree with most, but I'm not gonna know.
Baseball, best friend, you better motherfucking recognize, bitch. Bye.
Creep.
Y'all know I love Loki. He's a youngster. The little youngster.
That's the creep.
But you know what? I ain't even gonna lie. Loki reminds me the most of my son because when Ichi is hella little, but he tall as fuck. Like when he get older, when he's fucking 15 and 16, he gonna be tall as shit and outspoken. You gonna shoot my baby? You know what I'm saying? Like he's a kid. My baby is one.
Loki
reminds me, like makes me think about.
Yeah, he is one.
He's like 15. He's a baby. He's only 15, y'all.
We try to keep
Loki, nobody wants to see your tonsils in.
I am not a human.
Shut up.
Yo, bro.
I still have stuff to finish up with. I'm sorry.
Move, Loki. Stop in a creep, dude.
It's been like poo-poo down there.
I mean, it is an ass, isn't it?
He's 15, and he likes to have fun. And he likes to joke around, and he feels very comfortable in that home with the protest. Thank you. Everybody's like, oh, Bella's on welfare and she's broke and doesn't work. I had my first job at 10 years old. My grandmother had a cafe and I was like the busser and the waitress and the janitor and all the shit. Hey. I'm like, then I had a work permit. It was working at McDonald's as a teenager in high school. And I worked at Afterthought. And I sold jewelry and I had a piercing license. I'm like, then I went to AC Transit, which is the like bus system in Oakland.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I worked for AC Transit during college as a bus monitor. Like, no, I've always had a job. I've always worked. And when I wasn't working, I was trying to find a job. You know what I mean? So I'm like, all these trolls, that's fucking racist. But that's racist as shit. To be like, Bella's, what? If she's on welfare and she's broke and she's this, that, and that, and the other.
All black people are.
Right, all black people.
I heard on my way over here from downtown, I literally had to stream like.
Thank you, Cardi.
Through Bluetooth and like listening to you just screaming at CNN.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that just happened. Yeah.
I saw them leaving as I got here.
Yeah, that happened. They left because we screamed at them.
Yeah.
It was me and Bassa.
Sarah Seidner.
I was like, that was streamer fun right there. That was streamer fun. That was streamer protest. We ran the media. Go away. We got this. Go away. You can go fucking steal our YouTube videos later.
Right,
don't credit us.
In your vibe.
Right, exactly.
Go away.
So what else did you see? What were they trying to? What was the story they were trying to run?
Huh?
Could you even hear the story they were trying to?
No, I don't know. She said in the voice they want justice for something she was saying, and then it was just like, you be lying.
Yeah, yeah.
We want you to tell the truth. Yeah. Since you talking about what we want, right. Truth. Right. Shit. Right. Fuck.
Because last night CNN was here with one of the major anchors over here while everyone was having the big potluck and the drum kit over there. And one of the really big anchors was here.
Don Lennon or whatever.
No, not Don Lennon. He's the skinny white guy. He's one of the big anchors though.
Look, I'm like, man.
Anyways,
I care not.
If I heard the name, I'd recognize it. And they were doing a weekend wrap up, and I thought that was reasonable. And it seems strange that tonight, I don't know, it just seems strange that they would have CNN out here. They would all of a sudden, after weeks of St. Louis being in charge and them being fairly level headed about things compared to Ferguson, which always had riot police right up there arresting 8 people a night, that they would all of a sudden start enforcing the noise ordinance and the impeding traffic kind of deal.
I'm sorry, Brent. Hey, can we get a fact check on the Anon Stud? I'm sorry, I just don't know you, Anon Stud. Is it true that Senator Nasheed is refusing bond and that she will be staying the night in jail? Can we please get a fact check on that before I announce it to the crowd? They say her chief of staff is calling it an act of civil disobedience.
So it was.
Okay, so what I'm hearing, are you guys ready?
Make sure that it's known.
St. Louis doesn't do time served anymore. So she's refusing bail. That means she should be locked up for 3 days and then get out with a new court.
Okay, wait. Hold on. Hold on. They heard me announcing that. What'd you say? Can you repeat that?
St. Louis doesn't do time served anymore. Hey, man, I resent that. I resent that. But I resent that, though. St. Louis does not do any time served anymore. You know what I'm saying? You do 3 days max, and then they let you out with a new court date if you don't post bond. So if she's not in whatever jail for 3 days, I'm not trying to hear the shit for disobedience. No.
Okay.
She ain't talking about nothing.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? It's easy to chill in jail when you called in reservations to go to jail.
Right.
Yeah, that makes this a little easier. So I'm not hearing what they're talking about.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for that lesson.
Yeah. they playing games, man. They playing games. Yeah, of course they are. The thing is, we've been quiet for too long, man. We've been letting people get over. We've been letting these politicians cook. We've been letting the media cook.
Thank you, everybody, for confirming.
We got to fight back.
My brother.
We got to fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
I feel like y'all should come out here with pumpkins. I know y'all came outside with pumpkins. I'll just get arrested.
They say move back. We say fight back. Move back.
Fight back.
Move back.
Fight back.
Move back.
Fight back.
Move back.
Fight back.
Move back.
Fight back.
Move back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Back up. Back up.
We want freedom. Freedom. All these racist ass cops. We don't need them.
I said, back up.
We don't need them, freedom. All these racist ass cops. We don't need them,
I said, back up.
We want freedom,
All these racist ass cops.
We don't need them,
I said, back up.
We want freedom,
All these racist ass cops.
We don't need them,
Back up.
We want freedom,
All these racist ass cops.
We don't need them,
I have not seen STL Dagger, you guys.
Who shut shit down?
We shut shit down.
Who shut shit down?
We shut shit down.
You don't give a fuck shit.
We gon' shut this shit down.
You don't give a fuck shit.
We gon' shut this shit down.
Who shut shit down?
We shut shit down.
Who shut shit down?
We shut shit down.
They don't give a fuck shit.
We gon' shut this shit down.
They don't shut us down.
We gon' shut this shit down.
Y'all say Mike! Y'all say Brown! Mike!
Brown!
Mike!
divide and fall.
United we stand.
Divide and we fall.
We do this for Mike Brown.
We got the fight back.
Racism means
we got to fight back.
Discrimination means
we got to fight back.
Equality means
we got to fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Fight back.
Slide the phone.
All right, can I get everybody's attention so I can give you an update on Senator Nasheed?
Yes.
On the firefly.
The update is this. She is a protester. Hold on, first off, she's been out here every day. She's working on other stuff. Whatever, man. So check this out. This is the deal. She is not getting out tonight. She is not getting out tonight.
Why? Come over here.
Why?
What are the charges?
We have no idea what the charges are.
So they're probably going to release her at 11 a.m.
Antonio French said that she's refusing bail. Is that true? Antonio French is tweeting that she is refusing bail.
Oh, she's refusing.
I have no idea.
Okay. It's on his Twitter. I'm just asking because that's what I saw on his Twitter.
We've been right here. We just was told that she's not getting out.
Oh, okay. Okay.
We just relayed the message.
Okay. Okay.
She's not getting out. Right.
She got it first. She's somewhere getting that $700,000.
Yeah. Okay.
That's right. Yeah. Antonio French don't know what he's talking about.
I'm just asking. All I know is that Antonio French is saying it on his Twitter, but I don't know if it's confirmed, you know, through any other source yet. I haven't shut down the
show. Because they treat her like they treat everybody else. What it like that?
Courtney says it's confirmed, Bob, so I don't know.
They got to give it back. That's all he ever do. They kiss his ass. The ones who they should be going off on now, saying nothing about. Shit, Jamilah is the one that's in state senate right now fighting for stuff.
Right.
So you know who you're going off about. You get mad because she ain't been out here every single day.
It says it's confirmed being KP. Who is KPLR? Channel 11 News is the one who said that she's going to be refusing bail tonight. So it came out on Channel 11.
When he got that $500,000, Katie donated some hats and gloves down. You know what he told me? Walmart and Walgreens and Hannah. I went back the same day.
Who said that?
You got $500,000.
Who said that?
Antonio French. He ain't want to up no damn hats and gloves for the protest. But you get a little van and want to come out here and distribute some goddamn pizza. We get our own pizza and drinks down here.
That's true.
We need some warm.
Yeah.
Shit, fuck that. I don't like him. And I don't like you read that on your Twitter.
Message from protesters to Antonio French.
Oh, wait a minute.
Bring us some warrant. Don't bring us no damn pizza.
Can you have that attention, please?
Update that y'all motherfuckers might do care about you, dig? Tanya and her daughter, you know, motherfuckers been out here every day. They were whooping ass at the Rams game. They are out tonight. Yeah.
was doing jail support earlier. The people that we were waiting on to get out have been released. These protesters were spit on by Rams fans when they went to go highlight the issue with Mike Brown.
We got to fight back!
Mike Brown, man!
We got to fight back!
What dude just said, for real, them getting attacked yesterday. For real, the ladies that got attacked by the guys yesterday could go press charges on that guy. He's trying to take that flash.
That's right. That's right. It's strong arm. Strong arm robbery.
Approach charges, press charges on that arm, on them guys who spit on them and try to take that gun from them. That's the real truth.
You want to
fight fire with fire, we're going to do it like that. That's the way you do it, for real, though.
In the news,
they
tried to show the
whole
fucked up
picture.
Media ain't shit.
They've been doing that this whole time. I said that was strong arm robbery.
Media ain't shit.
Oh, she was the one dancing with the
hula
hoop that one night.
We got a public announcement.
I got a public announcement. Can somebody bring a fucking drum?
If you are out,
we have a drum.
Yeah.
I only got one
you
hand.
You are anti-police, which means you don't like the police. Please put your hands up. Don't tell him, Tomo. Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't
shoot!
Hands up! Don't
shoot!
Hands
up! Don't
shoot! Hands up!
Don't shoot! Hands
up! Fuck the police!
FBP!
Fuck the police!
FBP!
Fuck the police!
FBP!
Fuck the police!
Fuck the police!
Crazy. It's been attributed to free what, you guys?
Mic check for the young lady with the head on.
I don't want a mic check.
That our beloved senator has a press conference in the morning already. I don't know how you can facilitate that from jail. But we're not out here to get no updates about that bullshit. That's not why we out here. Don't give us no more updates about that bullshit in her press conference. We'll watch the news.
The only reason we out here is for one reason. What's his name?
Mike Brown!
Mike Brown!
Don't mic check unless it's for Mike Brown. Thank you.
Hey, now.
Okay.
What if I really have the people united will never be defeated.
I am revoking your privilege.
That's a pile of hook right there.
You just got fired.
What you do? That's a pile of hook. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Wait, show me what democracy looks like.
We want freedom.
All these racist ass cops.
No justice!
No peace!
No justice!
Somebody please send me a link to that video on CNN where you can hear me.
You can't stop the revolution!
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 This is the revolution!
I'm short as fuck. I'm like my jacket all along, my pants all along.
Oh, you almost had it.
I can't get up here.
You almost had it.
give it a good.
You want to run up.
There you go. Come on. You got it.
Damn. I had you. Look, I'm trying to push her up on my leg.
I'm trying. I really
want it.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
No. She had my stuff.
There you go. Right there.
Thanks, Reggie.
Thank you. I'm short as fuck, y'all. I couldn't get up here. Thank you.
This is what democracy looks like.
No justice, no peace. No
rights,
no peace. No justice, no peace. No
rights,
no peace.
Come on. Get that one up there. You ready? One, two,
my God.
Hey, we about to launch our ass
immediate. I would have laughed.
Hey, you would have seen the police lean out like.
They got him.
They got him. Get him. See now, get him.
They're gonna lock me up.
I think it's a joke.
Well, now I'm jealous because it just took me forever to get up here. I needed help. Y'all, I needed help getting on top of this thing. They had to lift me. I kept trying. I'm so short. I could not get up
here. What do we want it now? What do we want justice? What do we want it now?
What do we want justice? What do we want it now?
Ferguson Live is right over there.
You got
to tell your followers that I'm single, but I only talk to activists.
So Loki said he's single, but he only dates activists. I already am national, but I travel by word of mouth instead of corporate funded commercials. So. But y'all need to donate them a drum, man.
Drum.
Coming out to
live from the drum man seat himself in front of FPD, Ferguson Police Department. What they know really like. I'm a peaceful protester, a little bit, you know it or not. I really am a peaceful protest.
Hey, I am out turning up for my breath.
I come to a city.
Hey, we gonna go from buckets to drum, and we gonna need y'all help, okay? Donate to appreciate. All right. My brown me.
We got to fight back.
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 men.
We got to fight back.
Fight brown men.
We got to fight back.
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 We got to fight back.
We got to shut this shit down. We got to shut this shit down.
The person in red is wearing an A9 mask and he's dancing, or she's dancing, or they're dancing with that glow in the dark stick. It has lights on it. It's cute. Bree found the clip, y'all. She's about to show it to me.
We'll never be defeated. The people united. We'll never be defeated. The people united. We'll never be defeated. The people united. We'll never be defeated.
I got my head shit down.
We shut shit down.
Who shut shit down?
We shut shit down.
Who shut shit down?
We shut shit down.
Who shut shit down?
We shut shit down.
Got my head.
Wait till y'all talk to them. You don't hear yourself.
They don't give us that shit.
We don't shut the shit down.
They don't give us that shit.
We don't shut the shit down.
They don't give us that shit.
We don't shut the shit down.
They don't give us that shit.
We don't shut the shit down.
Yes, good. Thanks, that's for the shit. Oh, we're not coming back on no more either. Did they pull somebody else on?
Convict, and that killer got to jail. The whole damn system is guilty as hell. She like, all right, let me get that done. Let me get that done.
Walk away.
Just drop the motherfuckers and walk away. You did good. You did
good. I'm sick to the chain. I can't create the beat.
Now you do not drum line.
No. But then again, why not?
I got. Where you going?
Y'all leaving? Damn, did it just smell like bleach?
Hey, I just thought that some kind
of... Okay, like cleaning something.
Yeah, yeah.
I got a nice whiff of it.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Oh, okay. No, thank you. But I definitely just smelled something.
I love you. I love you, and I most definitely did text you.
I like that.
Lock you in.
I'm not trying to.
I was looking for a call.
Hey, on the real, I got the card for a couple days. Let's link up and talk about some stuff.
That's fine.
Okay. Okay.
I'll call you, Bella.
Okay.
All of you,
I love you. I love you. You. I really do love them. So it's hella funny because CNN is on there like, you hella hear me. Like, I didn't realize. Like, you hear me blast into her shit. And then they cut and go, I'm sorry, we're experiencing technical difficulties. I'm like, that's idiocracy. We seem to be experimenting some technological differences. That, I don't know if you guys heard it. You might have heard it in the stream. Bree was playing it for me. I was hearing the CNN clip where I totally went in. Y'all lying! So y'all remember that article when they called me Occupy Oakland's Bell Rad? They was like, they got Oakland Police as the L Rad. We got Bella. She's the Bell Rad. It was like, y'all think y'all loud. We will unleash Bella.
The Fox people over there? They were like right by that sign. I think their van is still there. It's Fox 2 or Fox 2 and 11, I guess.
Yeah.
And the cameraman, they were like going to do a report, you know, or whatever. Yeah. And should I?
Thank you.
And the cameraman was like, they were talking about light and stuff. And she's like, you sure I don't need a light? He's like, well, you'll attract attention. I'm like, yeah. CNN attract attention. They got ran out of here. And she's like,
Yeah. My thing is, I wasn't talking shit. I didn't say nothing that wasn't true. I literally was defending on CNN to deliver me Ferguson news. It was between the live streams and like CNN and MSNBC. And when I'm telling you, the least consistent stories were from CNN. You know what I mean? It was like I would watch the live stream and it was like they would just blatantly fucking lie. And it was like they would use little bits and pieces of films to fit a narrative.
Do you remember when Sarah Seidner was here over in this area behind the police back when Ferguson had the riot cops that would come out all the time? And
They would interview people like right here.
Right, but remember, do you remember the night when they were pointing
Where's
people out in the
you
crowd?
Say, you gotta go. Nigga,
or maybe
you
that
gotta
was
go.
Maybe that was Reb Z.
I probably was.
I'm watching a clip from CNN. You crazy? You gotta go.
Oh yeah, no, you're watching No, because I thought Leon was bathroom going bathroom. I mean, Leon was like, yeah, because you gotta go.
You gotta go.
But it's the same video that I
saw. Everybody is on my stream going, bellaeiko shut down CNN with bathroom. Yes. They like big Ferguson. And media whores, get out.
Shout out to Reb, man.
Shout out to Reb, you've been holding it down.
This is my dude right here.
I'm gonna tell you now, if it wasn't
Reb is the trillest live stream. I'm gonna tell you, man. Reb got maced. He was like,
But he was like, oh, I'm still here. I'm still here.
He was like, pour the milk in my eye. What did the fire come to the point? Yeah, he was like, I was like, Reb got maced again?
Yeah, you know what?
They have no respect for our stream.
No, Reb is a shining example of what it really means to be a streamer in the field.
Yes.
When I was screaming at the TV, like, y'all motherfucking job is to get arrested with them. Don't leave them without cameras. Like, I would be screaming at the house, like, what the fuck is a media area? What the fuck is that?
Right.
Not leaving.
He's like,
not leaving. I know what was going on because Reb is in the fucking thing. Like, I don't even know, but I'm still here.
Reb doesn't even know he's getting maxed because he lives through his phone. So he's watching. Just be like, he's like, yeah, what's going on? Oh,
my phone's broken. I'm really here. I didn't say anything. My phone's broken.
I forgot. I was like, Reb, how did I see that coming? Like,
he was experiencing technical difficulties.
Right,
everything
he's like,
technical difficulties.
He like, somebody wipe my phone off.
I didn't get pepper spraying, I'm just crying.
Yeah. That's all. Like a streamer technical difficulty is we just got maced, yeah. Pepper sprayed, tear gas, locked up, beat. Those are our technical difficulties. Oh shit, we don't receive any corporate funding and our Wi-Fi bill is out the fucking hook. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, we don't get any fucking sponsorship to be out here, so we completely bankrupt ourselves for hotel rooms and shit to be out here. Like, you motherfuckers get paid to report the news. You literally, like, they pay for your Wi-Fi. You get a big fucking van. You get a whole goddamn easy up to protect your equipment. You get rental cars and hotel rooms and all the shit, and you fucking lying. Like, why? No, fuck that shit. And then motherfuckers, it's like, no. You know what I'm saying? So people who want to know the truth, the same people who are robbing Peter to pay Paul and figuring out what to do for dinner tonight are like, well, let me try to get $10 to a streamer. Let me try because I'm so desperate to know the fucking truth because I'm so tired of being lied to. And then you stand up in the middle of the fucking crowd like you have some journalistic integrity. Like, what the fuck? Get the fuck up out of here. Bye. You are a police camera. The police are watching my stream. That's not a lie. Everybody should know that. Don't never get it twisted. They always watching the streams. But the difference is the narrative that's being put out to the society. What also matters is the fact that I'm here to film police misconduct. These are not professional protesters. They did not have thousands of dollars in training seminars to teach them how to protest effectively. But these motherfuckers are particularly egregious because you have had classes on how to not only uphold, but to obey the fucking letter of the law, and you are not doing that shit. So that is my job. That is what I'm here to do.
To me,
come on.
No, you take the tax dollars and you talk about, oh, black people don't pay taxes. If I walk to the motherfucking store and buy a goddamn bottle of water and you charge me 10-cent tax on that shit, I have fucking paid taxes. It don't even matter. Most black people are so far below the poverty line, we don't even got a fucking file. So that's why it's like, no, we are tax-paying citizens. We contribute to infrastructure. We contribute to education. We contribute to every fucking thing. Most of us are Christian and manage to put money in the fucking collection plate. But we don't have money. So it's like, why the fuck do you continue to criminalize the same people who give their last for some sort of law enforcement and protection, but we don't get that. You are everybody else's law enforcement to protect their bubble and reinforce stereotypes, which is fucked up because then you send the Uncle Tom token nigga out to fucking talk to us when it's the police department that's 90-something% white in a city that's 80-something% black. All of a sudden you find black officers. You are slapping us in the face. We are not fucking ignorant.
Bring it up,
yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. I'm ready to shut shit down.
Are they looking out the window?
I'm ready to shut shit down.
Bring it up to the people. In the fucking fire station.
Ray, walk away. Walk away.
I'm like, I might cuss, but at least what you're getting in is the truth. You know why it's the truth? Because do they run me out of here? Are they running me away? Wow. Are they saying, Bella, you lying, get the fuck out of here? Are they saying, Bella, come get this, Bella. Come talk to us. Get this out because nobody else will get this. Nobody except the live streamers. So you got people who pick up their phone because they like, I'm not getting the truth. So don't call me. I'll say I'm not a journalist. If Glenn Beck is a fucking journalist, I'm a goddamn journalist for sure. If Rachel Maddow is a journalist, I'm a fucking journalist.
I'm gonna tell you what I know. West Coast could be our favorite motherfucking word is fuck.
And hella.
Y'all be like, yes.
I hella don't give a fuck. And I give no fuck. Fuck hella serious. Fuck you about this. Fuck all that shit. I give no fuck. Ask me if I give a fuck. All of them are gone. I attached all my fucks to prayers and now they're gone. I'm like, I keep waiting on it to be answered that I could be human and walk down the street. But they gone. I gave them to God. Now he gives fucks, I don't.
You finna hate.
I'm not trying to compare her to Glenn Beck. I was just trying to put a balance on the spins. Like Glenn Beck, Rachel Maddow, really doesn't matter. If they're journalists, then I also fall well within that category. And the ACLU happens to agree. That's already been decided. Specifically me. I don't know every single streamer, but I'm saying that the ACLU happens to agree that I am a freelance journalist to be fucking respected. So if you don't like my language, refer to my poem when I said to stop paying attention to the language and pay attention to the reason why I'm so upset that the only language I can find to describe myself is fuck.
Well, man, we going everywhere. Fuck that.
Thought you knew.
Bam.
Thought you knew, man.
Thought you knew.
Thought you business. Thought you knew.
Yeah, she looked upset and I kind of felt bad for her, but not really. She got a paycheck. I don't get no check for this shit. I got to stand out here and ask people who are struggling just as much as me to help me be out here. So I have no sympathy for somebody who gets a fucking check to stand out here and lie comfortably in your little cute outfit. Like, you're not fucking running around getting tear gas and shit covering these protests. You don't got a gas mask in your goddamn van so that you could be out here making sure that you get the story. So don't tell me shit about journalistic integrity. You buy whatever the fuck they tell you and then you perpetrate that as news. Yeah. I give no fucks.
What'd you say? Hey, I went to the gas
tank. Reb, you gonna be up for a second?
I gotta get some, like,
cold
weather gear.
Hey, dear. Did Nick ever send a thing to Kinko's for you to pick up? Did you talk to him?
No, somebody else.
Okay. Okay.
I just need something to have on.
They just left to go to California. That's why I was wondering if he had even had time.
No, I appreciate it, though.
Well, if you ever need it, even just get it from him just in case. Yeah. So if you, I mean, fuck it. Where to? You also broadcast to my site.
Right.
Whatever. You just feel good. I used to when I was covering Occupy. I did bellaeiko Media and I did Fresh Juice Party. Like, I had two press badges. I went to two different sites.
Yeah, that worked.
You know what I mean? Just get it. Because you, when you go live, you broadcast to my site. You know what I mean? I tell everybody to go to you. So we officially, if nothing else, are affiliates.
Yeah, I gotta get my stuff set too.
Okay, so I'm about to put this on mute real quick. I'm putting it on mute real quick.
Yeah, so anyway, I'll talk to you more about that later. All right. Hey, I haven't seen you in a bit. How you doing? I guess
what?
All right.
You know, Bella the Trillers, man. We don't get no fucks. She hella, they got Bella hella fucked up.
That's pretty much. I say fucked up, twisted, and confused. That's pretty much. Y'all just got me on all fronts. I don't give no fuck. Get down with the get. Oh, particularly egregious.
Right, she pulled the words out.
I was like, come on, SAT.
On everything, I'm using it tomorrow. Everything I love, I'm using it tomorrow.
Excuse me, you being particularly egregious in this line at the grocery store taking all day. I got shit to do. And my shit ain't particularly egregious.
Is that hey, making fun of me? Making fun of me.
My shit ain't particularly greasy. Okay, it ain't egregious.
You know, we really are always so angry.
Sometimes we not so angry all the time.
I'm saying you gotta laugh.
I was about to say you got the lie to laugh to keep from crying.
You see every part of Kayla tonight. I was mad. I cried. Now I'm laughing.
But you know what? Let me tell y'all something. That drum helps increase y'all. It helps increase y'all morale. Like y'all get them chants started. But it's something that happened when that beat dropped. The tears stay at bay, and y'all are able to stay a little bit more lighthearted, but definitely passionate. And that is something that I keep saying. It's like, you know, people are like, that's frivolous, but no, it's a necessity, because when you out here, you really do have to find ways to maintain your sanity. You got to keep your morale high. And with us in Oakland, it was bring the fucking speaker out, attached to the car battery, and we bumping Fuck the Police by every artist that got a Fuck the Police song. We on one. But out here, your style is different. You know what I mean? And the drum is something that's unique. And it's beautiful, and it's celebratory. It's something that's really traditional to Black culture, number one. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just
preaching from behind the phone, baby.
Like, I'm just saying, like, it's not particularly egregious. And the First Amendment doesn't have a noise ordinance or hours. You know what I mean? So I'm of the opinion that y'all should have a couple drums as a backup in case they come with their fascist tendencies and try to encroach on y'all. Fucking First Amendment right to creative protest, peaceful protest. He's a fucking drum.
Does not have a noise ordinance or a business.
So it's just
come on.
Twist up the knife. They both play with a compilation.
I'm sorry, as much as I say fuck, we cannot have tone police inside the chat stream. We just have to keep the racist bullshit to a minimum. And if we not niggers, porch niggers, we, you know, everybody eat bananas and potassium and all that shit, but you know what I'm saying? Like, stop it. Stop it. That's what I'm saying. Right. Well, I'm just saying, if you so separate and you not part of Black people, because the oldest human is from Africa. So if you're not a part of Black people and you talking about monkeys, maybe you need to look in the mirror then. Is that what you aspire to be?
Where did you come from? Because when y'all crawl up from the caves. Y'all love Darwin and y'all evolution, right? Where y'all come from?
Listen, I don't see no world.
No monkeys evolving.
That's what I'm just saying.
What the monkeys that evolving?
Not even into it. I'm gonna check.
Yeah, let's not talk about the theory of evolution versus,
you
know.
Josh, you speeding? You are speeding!
Somebody pull his ass out.
Hey, they speeding!
Get him!
They speeding! They
speeding! Y'all ain't got shit better
than me. He ain't in the middle of the street.
Man, are they feeling here in the real life district?
Nelly, I believe, and T.I. already spoke out in against the protests, I believe, so.
Bro, Nelly came out here and told them to come up with better ways. And they was like, look, wait. And then he said something else.
Nelly and T.I. and him, right?
It was like, nigga, you rich. Of course you got options.
Exactly.
Right. Stand in front of your mansion telling me I'm good.
Exactly.
Wait a minute. I feel the way.
Better yet, though, not only are you rich, but you hella famous. Man, if you tell people to show up somewhere, they will be there, and they don't even have to be educated. They just want to be like you.
I'm a chill.
Yeah, you think
I'm a chill. Yeah, because I saw somebody come get him.
Said we came from Sumerians, not Africa. Let me learn my history then a little bit, Sumerians.
Hey, that nigga was bumping to the other side.
Bruh. Shit. As soon as he got a little money, he stopped fucking with St. Louis.
And he don't even invest back in
well, maybe don't have a Coke because they're really fucking abusive corporate entity that is right now completely draining all of the water out of California.
Which is in where?
Why don't you grow some chamomile and pick that shit out your garden and have some tea?
Yeah, stay college.
Where you at right now?
I'm just saying. Nelly raps. He's 90210. He's Beverly Hills with it, y'all. I'm from Cali. I'm not even Beverly Hills with it. I'm really from Oakland.
Hey,
that's a song. It's a real song. I do. I'm from Oakland. I'm from Oakland. That's the answer.
Yes, okay. Production management. And you can do things with that. Let's not down a trade school. No, but all it is in relates to Nelly is if he's got his name on it. That's it.
I mean, my thing is that my man, dog, he didn't say nothing for weeks, bro.
A long time.
And then this cat came out here and was like,
trying to tell people what to do.
Right.
We need to chill.
You know what I'm saying? We need to plan whatever. Bruh.
What's your plan?
Where your plan at?
Well, y'all got options.
We don't got options, bro.
Say, why don't y'all fund the movement and we'll discover all kinds of options? Other people be like, money don't make you happy. Well, motherfucker, I would love the opportunity to know because money will solve all my goddamn problems. And it's not that I'm
a little bit happier if I had a little bit more money.
Well, shit, if we had money, we wouldn't be concerned with first and 15th because we would be not living paycheck to paycheck on shoestring budgets, working two fucking jobs trying to survive in the one city we live in. Come on now.
Bella be speaking their truth.
She hit you with a line. You she only want to respond. You just let that. You just let that.
But you know what? It's whatever. We're not letting nobody cook, man. If the media can't cook, then these politicians can't cook.
You ain't about the right chick.
Nelly can't cook. Y'all don't be knowing nobody. Y'all be like, so-and-so.
I can cook.
We're going to check right now.
I don't know where we got to cook it from.
Where we got to cook, I know. I'm like, you talking about food? Because I get down in the
kitchen. My nigga Wise is hungry. He keep talking about cooking.
I am hungry as a mug. You know what I'm saying? I will admit.
He just buzzed out nowhere. Nelly can't cook either.
Right. That's what I'm saying. It's going to be all about food for real. You know what I'm saying? Because he came out here trying to sizzle or whatever. We been out here baking. You know what I'm saying? So, nope.
I actually don't know. Rather not 83. I was talking about a specific AR-15 that was built after the 80% lower receiver was ordered. I happen to have some machinist friends, so we happen to be shooting that with a 22 caliber. Do I know what standard issue is? I do not.
Peanut butter and
jelly. Whoa, jam.
Queen, white rice.
Miss Bell.
Good night, my dear.
It's always a pleasure.
It is always a pleasure. Thank you.
Peace out.
Good night.
Bye.
Good night, Nutter.
No. Yes, let us know when you get home.
Come on, y'all know I'll get home because I'm on Twitter responding to everything.
Bella, please get home safe.
I will love y'all right. Too.
I just wanted the one
We should just start a fucking hashtag on Twitter, nigga. Hashtag Ferguson home for all the protesters. And when we know that we made it home, just hashtag Ferguson home. Just go check, make sure that everybody on Twitter that is on the field. Hashtag Ferguson home. I made it. Well, it's good that we already operate in teams. Nobody really be leaving by themselves, and we had to talk about that. That's good. Yeah, plus you don't always be in their face to be readily identified and targeted immediately. I don't see you all.
I was out here for 2 months.
Oh, yeah, no, I know.
So, they know me by name anyway.
Oh, okay.
They can pull anybody over like the Centurio.
Oh, well.
I'm good on that. It's
we'll still be safe.
Relations. People acting like they know people up here.
Oh, yeah. No.
I know one person up here. It's SJ.
No, we was talking about all the new faces. I mean, I'm a new face, but
I respect that. You out here, you doing exactly what you came out here to do.
And I didn't keep my agenda secret, and I talk to people, you know what I mean? And I'm not trying to co-op, like, it's a little different. Everybody ain't like that. Oh, that's the homie.
Yeah, I thought he was trying to address you.
He's been real supportive on my stream, and then came out one day and was like, oh shit, it's you.
Yeah,
they watched him too.
What happened?
Someone
just
down there.
Lay down. 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 L
We gonna go see.
Are they protesters?
They damn sure they can.
Are they protesters?
I think so.
Yeah, they could.
My damn son.
Look, this is how we are now. We don't know. People want to go see.
Hell yeah.
So everybody's kind of dying down. And not that the night is over.
It's just time to turn up.
It is time to turn up, but a lot of people are leaving.
Can you see what it is?
Who wanna go? Go on over
here. Yeah, we can see it. Where are you at? Where are you?
Hashtag Bella's at home in Ferguson. Yeah. Yeah, I am. I feel very much at home. Oh my God, I need some of that. It's Crystal Geyser water. Y'all don't even understand. They've been buying like Schnucks bottled water and I cannot fuck with that. It tastes funny. I immediately tasted it and was like, what's wrong with the water? You know, I'm from California. I'm a water snob. We gotta drink bottled water all the time.
Oh yeah.
Oh. All right, so I'm gonna shut down. I'm gonna try to head over and see who's being pulled over. I'll pull up the stream for a little bit, about 5 minutes, but then I'm probably gonna call it a night. I gotta get back to the baby. Single mom can't always stay out all night, but y'all know that's more my style. But I gotta figure out the baby. So I'm gonna go do that.
Turn down for what?
So I love y'all. Let me know when the chat lag catches up so I can shut down without it being a premature shutdown. And
girl, you know we love you too, but we love you more. Don't worry about it. We're gonna learn how to find your ass a babysitter. Who wanna babysit?